this big-ass car when you started going out with him? Was it his big car that attracted you to him?
Bob loves this car. It is a miracle he lent it to me.
You know what we should do?
Thomas, no.
Hear me out.
No more revenge plots, no subtle psychological torture, no systematic destruction of Bob's life over the course of sophomore year.
This one's all about the car. You'll like it. It involves accelerant and a cliff.
And I'm driving, right?
You jump out at the last second.
I don't want revenge.
Audrey, Sideshow Bob of the station wagon and the ponytail just dumped you, kicked you out. Let's make him pay. Let's show him what happens when you cross Audrey Marsh.
I just think the mature thing, really, would be to forget all about Bob and go on with my life. Get back my Billy Bragg and Wilco CD and go on with my life.
He has your Mermaid Avenue CD?
I lent it to him over the summer. Damn it, that was my favorite CD. I'm such an idiot.
Wasn't that my CD? Didn't you borrow that from me and never return it?
I traded you.
For what?
Guitar Gods of the 70s.
You took some crappy discount CD, put it in my room, kept my good CD, and gave it to Sideshow Bob?
And now I need it back. See, that is a reason for a mission.
How did I get 80s dance explosion?
I traded you for Prince. Controversy.
Squirrely girl.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up, Thomas?
Hi.
Hey. Isn't that Bob's girlfriend, Audrey, from our floor last year?
Yes.
Well, what are they doing out there? It looks like she's moving in.
Audrey's taking the spare room, Bruce. Thomas told you.
First of all, it's not the spare room, it's the weight room. It's the whole reason we picked this house. It had a room for my weights.
There aren't any weights in it.
That's not the point. The point is, it's the whole reason we picked this house. Plus, I don't like this, her moving in. I mean, this was supposed to be a self-contained, masculine environment. Guytopia, remember? And now I can't be myself. I can't walk around naked.
Were you planning on walking around naked, Bruce? Because that's not my idea of Guytopia.
Okay, fine. Why can't you sleep on the couch?
Because we found her behind the porno theater, and she's bound to find that out someday.
So we could go in from the outside, grab the CD, and go. A daring daylight robbery, like on the news. Although we should try not to end up on the news.
He's on the top floor. We need a telescoping fire truck ladder. I think I can get one.
Oh my God!
I know a guy.
Look at this.
Audrey, nobody needs to see that.
These aren't mine. Whose are these?
Don't ask me.
Well, if they aren't mine, then Bob had sex with someone else in this car.
There are other explanations.
Like what?
Maybe Sideshow Bob was driving while someone else had sex in the back seat.
Maybe someone borrowed the car.
I bet you Bob gets a lot of requests for this car.
Prom night. Teenagers want a snazzy ride.
Parades. Grand Marshal's gotta look good.
Thomas, I don't think these belong to the Grand Marshal.
Are we gonna get started?
Where's Audrey? Does she know there's a house meeting?
She's probably filling the medicine chest with tampons.
Let's just try and get through the rest of the year without saying tampons.
What about tampons?
You're in charge of tampons.
For who? The entire school? Did the dean call?
Huh? Just the house. Just don't put them on the grocery list.
What grocery list? There is not going to be a grocery list.
We're starting the house meeting.
Good, because I have an important question for the entire house.
We'll get to it. Everyone will get his turn. Okay, first, the cleaning schedule.
Is that a list?
You made a list?
Did everyone make a list? This is just to anticipate any problems before they occur. It's not that different from what we had in the dorms last year.
That's why we moved off campus, so we could make our own rules.
That's what I'm trying to do, Bruce.
I'll take the list.
All right, fine. Let's not even have a house meeting, but I'm not responsible for anything that happens all year.
No, there'll be anarchy. Jason, you have to save us with your loosely enforced list of rules.
Okay, is it my turn now?
Don't ask me.
Cleaning schedule, garbage duty, shower schedule, Hawaiian night, roommate mixer.
With name tags.
Okay, very funny. That is not on the list.
How long is the list? Because I have tryouts.
Tryouts for what?
Basketball. Walk-on tryouts are at 5. I'm gonna get there at 4:30 and warm up.
Varsity basketball, NCAA basketball?
Yeah.
You're trying out to be a walk-on for the Sagamore Eagles, the team that last year went to the Final Four with a largely sophomore starting lineup.
Yes,
Fred,
but
you're not even the best basketball player in the house. We can beat you at basketball.
Okay, I'm not good on asphalt.
Fred, I beat you at horse last year, remember?
You had H-O-R-S.
That's true, I did. Good luck.
Thank you.
Can I have my turn now?
Yes, the floor is yours.
Those are panties.
See, this is what I'm talking about.
Does anyone know whose these are? I found them in Bob's car.
They aren't yours.
Look, does anyone know anything about Bob cheating on me over the summer, Jason?
I'm pretty sure Bob didn't cheat on you over the summer.
And you would know. You're his friend. But whose are these?
I don't know.
I knew it'd be like this.
Bruce, they aren't mine.
Audrey, I don't think we're going to resolve this here.
Okay. Fine.
All right. I've read the list, and I've scaled it down to one item. That one item is... Time Cop.
What about Time Cop?
We need to limit the number of Time Cop viewings in this house.
It's my TV.
We don't care.
I've never seen Time Cop.
Oh, you will.
Is it good?
It's not.
It's the best movie ever made. Jean-Claude Van Damme is a cop that travels back through time. The thing is, his wife...
Don't spoil it. I haven't seen it either.
While it is admittedly a shining jewel in the crown that is the collected works of Jean-Claude Van Damme, it's one stupid-ass movie.
We're gonna sit down and watch it today. You'll change your mind.
I've seen it, Bruce. I roomed with you last year. I dreamed I wrote my freshman English final on Time Cop.
One viewing every 2 weeks. All in favor?
It's my VCR.
Fred, you paying attention?
You can't tell a man when to watch his art. It's un-American.
Still a majority. Once every 2 weeks, motion carries. Meeting adjourned.
Okay, this meeting sucked.
Hey, Fred. Good luck.
Hey, Fred, show him this one. This is your best shot, your one-handed backward blind shot.
That's my secret weapon.
What's up with the bagpipes?
I don't have any bagpipes.
Are you telling me that you don't hear bagpipes?
I hear the bagpipes. It's someone from across the yard at Dippa.
We live behind the foreign exchange student's house. Oh, you know what that will be like. They'll put up a flag for Bastille Day, and then they'll leave it up, like, all year. And then they'll borrow our rake and pretend not to understand the word rake when we ask for it back.
We don't have a rake.
See, that's probably because they borrowed it from the tenants last year and returned, like, this potholder in its place. We're lucky to have this potholder.
I brought the potholder from home. You're a xenophobe. I like bagpipes.
Jason, would you like to trade rooms? Because it's like a bagpipe convention in my room. It's like VE Day at the Scottish Embassy.
I'll think about it. No.
Hey, can I ask you a favor? You can say no.
What?
Can you find out from Bob if he cheated on me?
Audrey, can't you just let this go?
I'm laying awake nights thinking about the purple panties and listening to Seamus McTransfer student learn his scale, so apparently the answer is no. Is it possible that Bob could have cheated on me without you or me knowing?
Even if he did, it doesn't matter now.
You said he didn't.
I said I'm pretty sure Bob didn't cheat on you over the summer, which is true.
So is there some other time, like last year, when you think he did cheat on me?
You should ask Bob.
Jason, this is important to me. Do you know something?
Ooh.
Thomas, what?
Nothing. You just look nice, that's all.
Shut up. What do you know?
How come we never have any beer?
New York state law.
What do you know? When did Bob cheat on me?
On that ski weekend.
With who?
Some girl. She doesn't go here.
You went on that ski weekend.
Sideshow Bob didn't take me into his confidence.
You have no sack. You are a man without a sack, Chucky.
Who's Chucky?
Jason is Chucky.
Sorry about your sack, man. Does anyone else hear bagpipes?
Yes.
Oh, thank God.
She's calling me Chucky.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Hey, hey, you're in this too.
No, I'm not. She knows everything she needs to know.
Don't try to defend Chucky.
I'm just saying that you might decide to let this one thing go. It's over, you're fine.
I'm not fine. I mean, I know that the worst is over, but I am nowhere in the vicinity of Fine.
All right. What will it take to see Fine again?
Well, first the bagpipes would have to stop for good. No, first I would have to get back my Billy Bragg and Wilco CD.
Who's Billy Bragg and Wilco CD? But
you can have it. I just don't want Bob to have it. Can you help me get it?
No.
Why not?
I already got it.
This is mine. Does Bob know you took it?
The important thing is that's the CD right there in your hands. And I'm working on the bagpipes.
Thanks. Can I have it?
Only if I can keep Guitar Gods of the 70s.
You didn't kill Bob, did you? It was okay if you did.
I realize you two are only here as part of the grand work-study scam for roommates of the assistant manager, but did you think about answering that ringing phone?
I have a drawer.
Jason told me to read this important memo. He said that's all I had to do, just show up, sign in, and read a few memos.
Well, I haven't read this memo. Let me take the time to do that right now while a potential customer waits on the phone. To all employees from Jason, please.
Is anyone getting the phone?
Jason's roommates and I are very busy. We're hardworking and well-qualified to have these jobs.
If you want to know about hard work, try working video for one day. Every tape that leaves the store comes back later. I'm like Sisyphus over there. Bluefish, this is Shelly. No, this is not the suicide hotline. Yeah, I know. They printed the wrong number on the flyers. How would I know the number? My life is fine. 4477, extension 4477. You're welcome. How did you know the suicide hotline number? Did you call them?
No.
I thought maybe since you found out about Bob.
Look, I'm not gonna kill myself over Bob and some ski weekend slut. I was gonna dump him anyway. Nobody seems to believe that.
I believe that.
You do?
Sure. You can do so much better than Bob. You just need to do something with your hair.
Shelly, I appreciate that you seem to be trying to be nice, but I think that you'll agree that you and I are not friends.
I know, but you don't have any girlfriends, so I was pretending.
That's not necessary.
Okay. But, there's something you should know about the ski weekend slut. Not because it matters, but because everybody else knows.
Everybody else knows what?
That she's Jason's cousin.
So, Bob slept with some girl who doesn't go to Sagamore. Is there anything else that you remember about this girl?
Her parents are my aunt and uncle.
Didn't your cousin Brooke come to visit you last year one weekend when I was out of the dorm?
Brienne.
So this wasn't just a one-time thing? So a lot of people knew? A lot of people who lived on the same floor as me?
Audrey, I didn't think it was any of my business. I didn't even think about it, really. It was all so unpleasant.
If you had been my friend, you would have said something. If Fred had known, he would have told me.
Bruce knew. He didn't tell you.
I hardly know Bruce.
Thomas didn't tell you.
Thomas didn't know.
Thomas knew what I knew. I thought if it was anyone's place to tell you, it'd be Thomas's.
Thank you for telling me that, Chucky. Thank you for always knowing exactly what information you think I should have. You knew. You knew about Bob. Next, Alanis is next.
Well, I tried putting that one in, but it burned the flesh off my fingertips.
It's my pick, Alex.
Shelly, this store is full of music. Some of it is the best music that ever existed. I mean, look around you, past the new releases. What's out there? Your favorite song is out there, Shelly, but you've never heard it because you've put Alanis on top of the play pile for the 47th time, and it's only the second week of school.
Look, Alex, I work in video.
Shelly, I'm going to do you a favor and put on some Joan Armatrading.
I have a customer. Put on Alanis.
You left your register unattended, which is unusual for someone so highly qualified to have this job.
Just shut up right now, Alex.
Hey, what happened to you? Are you all right?
Why do you care? You don't even know my name.
Your name is Audrey March. What's my last name?
I don't care. Just don't talk to me.
Audrey.
You lied to me. You knew everything. You let me stay with him. You let me look like a complete idiot in front of our entire floor and Bob's entire floor.
Bob's the one who made you look stupid.
You could have told me. You just thought that a real man would stick with his guy friends. You were afraid of what Bruce and Chucky would think if you took my side.
You don't know what I thought.
Hey, who's Chucky?
Jason's Chucky. Yeah, I don't get it either. You know, this song is not bad.
Yeah, you must learn to trust me.
Have a nice day.
Does his wife know he's traveling through time?
I don't think so. It's top secret. That seems to be key to the plot.
Does she realize he's Belgian?
Nobody seems to notice that.
Time cop!
Hey, this showing doesn't count. I didn't put it in. I didn't see the opening credits.
Do me a favor. Don't give up without a fight.
Hey, this definitely doesn't count.
What's this? Are we having a time cop intervention? Because I haven't even seen it once yet.
We're having a bagpipe meeting. We're going in after the pipes tonight.
Did anyone try asking him to stop playing?
That won't work. The song of the pipes is in the blood of the Scotsman.
Aye, and I'd fear he'd belt me with his haggis and drive me from the moors.
All right. In phase one, we surround the premises.
Where am I? There's no Jay.
C for Chucky, that's you. You're the lookout. You don't have to do a thing.
Why am I always the lookout?
I can answer that.
That's all right.
No sack.
Am I the point man? I want to be the point man.
Audrey's the point man. Where are you going?
Count me out.
Why?
Because I don't care about the bagpipes. And besides, you guys were supposed to be my friends too, not just Bob's, and so far, not even one of you has apologized.
I'm sorry, Audrey.
You didn't do anything. You know, you always know that you might lose a boyfriend, but I thought that you guys were my friends. I thought you were my best friend.
Now that Sideshow Bob's out of your life, I'm your best friend.
I thought you always were.
Go.
Don't go, man. She'll own you.
I need her for the mission.
Thomas, look, I'm sorry. It's not your fault that you don't want to be my best friend. You never said you did.
I have a best friend, Lloyd Wallerby.
That sounds like someone you're making up. That's a made-up name. Plus, you've never mentioned him before.
Sure I did. My best friend Lloyd, and you probably just forgot.
It's just that you have lots of friends, and I don't have that many, except for back in Albuquerque. I don't have that many friends to show for freshman year. Right now, I have Fred.
Remember last year when we went to the bridal show and pretended that you were pregnant and that I was going to marry you, even though you weren't absolutely sure who the father was?
It was either you or your brother Applejack, the Marine.
Longshoreman. I went along with you that day because you thought that would be fun.
It was fun. I had fun.
Okay, let's say it was fun. But the next weekend, when it came time to audition the band for the reception, you were with Bob somewhere and I had to take Bruce with me. He had that band play every Hootie song they knew. They knew a lot of Hootie, Audrey. After that, you never did anything with me without checking with Bob, who was always pretty much a loser anyway, even before this thing with Jason's cousin.
So why did you take his side? You don't even like him and you protect him.
It wasn't my intention to protect Sideshow Bob. Why do you think I call him Sideshow Bob?
Well, I always thought it was because of the time that he knocked over the Quickie Mart and pinned it on Krusty.
The man is a sideshow, Audrey. I always knew you were going to cut him loose someday. I just didn't know that you were going to find out he cheated on you because he lent you his car with incriminating underwear in the back seat. I was impressed with the level of stupidity on that one.
So you just thought that I would never find out? And you thought that that would be better?
Yeah. I still think so.
I just feel like everything I thought was true is a lie. I feel like I can't count on anything anymore.
I happen to know that isn't true.
How long have you known Larry Wallerby?
Lloyd Wallerby.
You said Larry before.
I did not. It's a real guy.
I don't think it is.
Downstairs, 2300 hours. Hurry up! Got it!
I'm not even sure if that was the right room. I just took something that felt bagpipe-like.
Bagpipes, good job. Why'd you take his passport?
It was dark. Ryan Steele, that's why you got all that Scottish. Quest, let's put the pipes back.
He'll get them back at the end of the semester.
But look at him dreaming about his trip to America.
Remember the music.
The pipes, the pipes! Caw-caw, caw-caw!
Did you see someone?
No.
Why are you running like that?
I don't know. There's too many men in one area. We need to clear out. Gave us security.
Play it cool. You're the Iceman.
No, don't look over here! You're Chucky! We need to bring him in.
You guys, let's leave Chucky here. Come on, please, pick a side. Pick my side.
Let's go.
Go, go!
You're really putting me in the car? Why? Why? I so don't deserve this. He's looking for the pipes. He's heartbroken. His grandfather gave him those pipes when he left for America.
I don't feel guilty. It was those pipes or my sanity. You know what's behind all those misdialed suicide hotline calls I take.
Bagpipes?
That's right, the pipes.
Chuck, where you been?
Apparently, our disguises had a flaw.
A flaw?
Yeah. They tended to make us look suspicious.
Maybe it would have been smarter not to wear disguises at all.
In retrospect, that might be true.
Perhaps in retrospect, no disguises would have been the smarter way to go.
We should keep that in mind for next time. Maybe no disguises.
Yeah, maybe not.
Are we even now?
It depends. You went to the campus security office, and they asked you why you were wearing a wig?
They had certain questions about the wig. Photos were taken. I'm on a list.
You like lists.
And are there any plans for your cousin Brittany to come visit you this year?
Brianne, no. And just for the record, I apologize.
All right. I'll add it up and see where we stand.
Fair enough. Good night.
Good night.
Hey, we should call Larry Wallerby.
Lloyd Wallerby.
You should call Lloyd Wallerby, tell him all about it, see what Lloyd has to say.
Lloyd doesn't have a phone. He's in Ecuador. Lloyd's with the Peace Corps.
No, he isn't.
Yes, he is. It's a real guy, Audrey.
I don't think it is.